tender love, your tender mercy, your loving compassion that we're still in the land of the living. We pray for the situation in our country. Pray for the president and pray for the Congress. Pray for the judiciary system. Pray for the governors and mayors. We pray for your holy presence. Your will be done. We pray for the great event that will take place on Saturday in Washington, D.C. The return is the time. Oh God, this country needs prayer.
Yes, God.
We pray for those participants, Dr. Graham and others.
Yes.
Pastor Khan. Others who will be participating in that great gathering. Bless them, Lord. In Jesus' name. We pray this prayer. Amen.
Amen.
He's all I need. We are praying for that great event that will take place on Saturday.
Amen.
In Washington, D.C. with much prayer. And it's just, I'm just overwhelmed with praise with God. I just thank God for when I am seeing more commercials where there's prayer that's being introduced. Earl Jones, I think the actor, was reading the scriptures. There's one that comes on about, have you read your Bible? And it's one that says, where will you go after? You're going to die. That came on the network, television network, says, you're going to die. But if you're not saved, where will you go? I said, thank you, God. Don't tell me God is not moving. Or you, the leaders are going. But God is talking loud.
Amen.
Regardless of what you say, God is going to be heard.
Yes.
And then it's up to you to make a decision. I just want to say that we're here at Great St. John. We're organizing an outreach ministry. What is the name of that ministry?
Ministries for Jesus.
Missionaries
for Jesus. Headed by President Raquel Botkin, Vice President Adrian Brown.
Yeah.
Man.
And that committee for now, Sister Veronica Jarrett and Sister Elaine Barfield. And they will, their uniforms, they came to me, they made an agreement to wear white.
Yeah.
That's white dress. Have their little hats on. They're going to have their badges. I said, okay. You know you're supposed to look the part.
Yes,
you need the part.
Yes.
You don't come to church. When you used to go out on them dates, you went and bought that $50, $100, whatever you was wearing. No way in the world you should come to church looking like you're going to pick cotton. You're going to pick tomatoes or something. You should be going looking your best for God. Tennis shoes in the church. You don't wear tennis shoes on a date. That's a shame before God. That's a disgrace. You're always supposed to look your best before God.
Amen.
All right, I'm done with that. And at this time, the facilitator for our biblical counseling. Now, we've been doing this for almost, some time now. And we just want to continue on because we talked about child abuse tonight. Correct? I had a young man when I was in high school, when I was in St. Louis. I was so shocked. In the church, you had homosexuals molesting a boy. One of my friends got molested. He was 16 or 17. It was so bad. And he said, I don't know who to go to, Marcus. I don't know who to turn to. I said, why don't you take the police? He said, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm afraid. So we're going to talk about this. You'd be surprised what's going on, right? Not so much outside the church.
Right.
All right,
just around the
facilitator. Yeah.
Good evening.
know the things that we suffer. There is nothing that is taboo to God.
Amen.
Nothing that should be taboo to us.
Amen.
Amen.
So just starting off, well, I just want to read this. I just want to explain what biblical counseling is. It's an approach to counseling that uses the Holy Bible to address the issues in the lives of individuals, couples, and families. Biblical counseling addresses the heart.
Yes, yes.
So our Christian disclaimer, okay? Biblical counseling is a faith-based approach to addressing the commonplace issues we experience in life as human beings and providing guidance as well as assistance through the Holy Bible towards resolving those issues. We do not or have ever instructed anyone not to consult their doctor or physician, stop taking your prescribed medication or supplements, or to disregard the advice of your medical and other professionals. What we do is we exercise our constitutional rights, and it is our religious freedom to express, practice, and affirm our Christian biblical beliefs in reference to the Holy Bible and obedience to God's word.
Yes, yes.
As witnesses to the power of faith in Jesus Christ, our Savior, it is now our mission and it's our passion as believers in Christ Jesus to extend that hope to all through biblical counseling.
Right.
So let's go into it now. Child abuse. This is just a brief summary or just a brief definition of what in general child abuse is.
All right.
It's physical maltreatment.
Mm-hmm.
Or sexual molestation of a child, an adolescent. So when I say child, child legally, they mean adolescent, that's ages 10 to 19 years of age. So
Right.
It's apparent that Hollywood, as well as the mainstream media, have no problems using sex to sell their franchise, even at the expense of promoting child sexual exploitation and pedophilia. From Variety.com, Cuties, backlash led Netflix U.S. cancellations despite nearly eightfold. Analytics firm said. The writer claims Netflix has defended Cuties, written and directed by award-winning French filmmaker Malmana Dacoury, arguing that it is a social commentary that makes the case about the dangers of sexualized imagery of young girls. The streamer has urged those who have renounced the film to watch it. So I also saw on the internet where they have this director of the movie. So what happened in the movie is they have these girls, they're all age 11, they're teenagers, they're kids, they're adolescents, but they're using, they're sexually exploiting themselves, they're doing these really sexually provocative dances to try to, get some money or try to get ahead in life or whatever. But she was trying to defend her movie and saying, my purpose for making this movie was to make people aware of it. And so they were asking her, why didn't you just do a documentary about the sexualization of children and sexual exploitation? She said, because they're about these movies. And she said, well, there are ways to make people aware of the issue than to put it in a movie. And so she defended her movie, and Netflix is defending her movie. Netflix's sentiments in response to the backlash over their clearly sexually provocative network original is shared by Hollywood and mainstream media in general when it comes to sexual exploitation of children in television and film. They defend this content, calling it art, and claiming that it's protected under the First Amendment. Consumers and families have to be vigilant concerning their children's use of media, devices, and streaming services. Also, California leads the nation in child sex trafficking activity. Involvement.com posted this. California has a huge sex trafficking problem, especially when it comes to adolescents. According to the National Human Trafficking Resource Center, NHTRC, the largest majority of the human trafficking cases reported in the U.S. each year originate right here in California. In fact, San Diego, Los Angeles, and San Francisco are three of the 10 worst child sex trafficking cities in the U.S. California, against slavery. Human trafficking is one of San Diego's worst criminal issues, second only to drug trafficking.
They have a long knife. There is a, from my understanding, a law now that lowers, sex, if a young man, 24 years old, have a sex with a child, 14, with their consent, they're not going to charge that person.
Wow.
And I tell you, we have girls in our house, and here they are, 14. They're under our jurisdiction. They're not under somebody else's jurisdiction. I'm just teaching the church.
Amen.
That goes beyond the scope. Even if you're 24 and you still consent, you committed fornication.
Right.
Do it the Lord's way.
Amen.
That's why we have biblical counsel.
Yes.
Now, that is to me, that's wholesale almost. That's really going beyond. And this is why the church is so important.
Amen.
The church is silent.
Amen.
On righteousness.
Amen.
I don't want any of my granddaughters. I got a granddaughter. We got a granddaughter. How old is she? She's 14 years old. And if there's a 24, say 21, 18-year-old.
Right.
For, sir, I have, that is not, that's not going to go over good.
Amen.
We go over good with the 17-year-old. You understand?
Amen.
It's becoming a sewer kind of. Anything goes.
Right.
The church is the only house of truth.
Amen.
Where you can have standards and morals.
That's right.
That's where we can't teach. We teach outside, but we sure teach in here.
Amen.
Membership.
Amen.
Amen.
Considered
wife said how she enjoyed drinking coffee with her. And I thought, how are we going to evangelize the world when we're doing exactly the same thing the world is doing? It starts in the church. If we don't set an example, then what the world, how our light will shine? When we have compromised, I remember the late Dr. Anderson said, there's nothing wrong with the church being in Corinth. But when Corinth gets in the church, then we have a problem. And we've seen in so many instances that Corinth is in the church. But thank God that for our biblical counsel here at Grace St. John at the Closet, which let us know that God has a system, has a way that we should live by and go by. If you follow His word, and He will help you, whatever infirmity you have, He will help you overcome those. You don't have to stand there.
Well, this is one of the reasons why we have biblical counseling to expose, to bring it home where there could be one in the church who have been raped by a member in the church. And there they both sitting on the same pew. Now, over time, the one who raped the victim becomes guilty in the heart. This is the place to rectify that.
Amen.
Because God deals with the heart. Behavior, I mean, it's dealt with in school, in prison. But God deals with the heart through His word. To have that person to come to realize that what they did to that man or woman was wrong. And the Bible says, go to thy brother. Get it right. And then both can feel comfortable as a brother and sister in the Lord from then on out. But here they are sitting in church. And this sister's holding this, harboring this hurt, knowing that this brother raped her, abused her, misused her. And the best thing to do, according to God's word, is go get it right.
Amen.
Look, I'm sorry. I messed up. Confession is made unto salvation. Yeah. Look, I'm very sorry. I didn't, you know, I was not right at that time. Or I just get it right.
Yeah.
That's up.
Yeah. That's right.
I mean, what more can you do? And then it's up to the victim to accept, and if not, wait a while, go back,
all right.
Or take somebody else. The Bible says, take another brother, sister.
Mm-hmm.
There have been men raped in the church.
Yes, that's right.
You have to say, man. Get it right.
Yeah.
That's what the Lord Jesus Christ died for.
Yeah.
He died that all might have a right to the tree of life.
Yeah.
Your sin is no blacker than my sin.
Right.
My sin is no blacker than yours. Get it right.
Yeah.
That's why we have the blood of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
I'm talking about if I did, you know what you need.
Right.
It's tough sometimes, but it's always right. You'll feel better.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So, sometimes it come back on you. You don't know how it may come back on you.
how to deal with certain things or even talk to others about. And then thank God for you, Pastor Scott. You said the church helps us to have standards so we won't just be all over the place.
Amen.
Amen.
I think we've covered a lot of territory tonight.
Man.
Just going back to those young women, the missionary reach out. We will have social distancing like we have now for those who will be in attendance. I just want to say about this lesson. This is a dynamic lesson.
Amen.
Make a joyful noise. It starts with you first.
Amen.
It really starts with you first. And the church is coming to my courts with thanksgiving.
Yeah.
How can the church come in, how can the church come into the courts when the church doors are closed?
Right.
The church is silent when it should be making a joyful noise. Coming to my courts with thanksgiving, and the church is silent.
Right.
This time now, the church should be the loudest,
yes.
Making a joyful noise,
yes.
Instead of silent.
Yes.
King Jehoshaphat had a great battle that the enemy was greater in number.
Right.
You look at the church now that's surrounded by the enemy, quote unquote. I'm talking about the unrighteousness that's going on. The darkness. Talking about homosexuality and murder and hatred now. I never seen so much hatred. We're praying for those officers that got shot.
Amen.
We're praying for the family of that young lady too.
Amen.
In Louisville. In that family. So we all minds matter.
Lighting
up. The soul, that's important.
Amen.
Life is a life. God he don't judge like us.
Right.
He made every man and woman and boy and girl. All lives are matter to him. So I'm getting back where Jehoshaphat and Judah was surrounded and they didn't have the manpower, but they had the God power. And the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob said, wait, but you don't need to do anything. You don't, and you know where they were? They were standing in a church atmosphere. Judah was standing. Read it for yourself. Go to 2 Chronicles in the 22nd and the 20th chapter. Read for yourself. Judah was waiting for a word, and the Spirit of the Lord spoke. And you know what they began to do? They began to praise the Lord. And the Lord came down, discomfited there, and killed the enemy. Don't tell me God won't do it. But you got to open your mouth and praise Him. We're not trying to advocate somebody to die. But God will take care of your enemy. The vengeance is mine. But we got to praise Him.
Amen.
Come into my court. But it first started before you get in the court.
Right.
God has done too much for you.
Amen.
Just to sit there and don't say, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You brought me another day. You put food on my table. You woke me up this morning. You gave me strength to walk this morning. You gave me strength to talk. God did that.
Amen.
We need to praise Him.
Amen.
Before you die, He gave it to
me. Amen.
Some got cancer.
Yes.
You can open your mouth.
Amen.
Praise Him.
Amen.
Yeah. Holy Spirit. Rest in the Bible, to the that's all, say amen.
Amen.